Hi, I'm Clinton Lindsay. Thanks for visiting my YouTube channel and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Spread the word and visit us once again. Thank you very much.
Hey, young lady, how are you?
People are... Hi, Mr. Lindsay.
I already said I can't believe I you this. Listen.
Really?
I must say to you, you know, from day one and you have sent me stuff and I send them back to you. Many a times, and I must say, you have improved a lot. Congratulations! And I listen to this album, and I'm like, wow,
is this really?
I'm quite impressed with the album.
Thank you so much. You know, it's funny, Mr. Lindsay. You know, it's funny. As an artist, you feel like you always sound like this because you remember "Love Me Forever."
Yeah.
You were the first one to play that song, and it still to me sounds good. A lot of people love that song in England.
Yeah.
So I feel like I sound the same. I don't know.
No, you have improved a lot. Take it from me. Because like I just said, you have sent me a lot of songs that what have I done with them? Send them back to you, right?
Some of them you don't like. Yes,
some
that
of
is true.
I don't like. No,
but the majority of them you like.
Yes, and I'm telling you, this album is a very good album. Congratulations. And Righteousness Reigns. It's not the sort of thing I hear from you a lot. What gives into this album have a mixture of genres and topics and subjects and so on.
Yes,
and I know by the credits that I got that you wrote most of the songs.
Yes,
went into putting this? Why this album? Why you put so much of you in this album? Tell me.
You know, everybody dying around me. I'm getting older and everyone's just dying and the state of the world, you know, I'm a deep thinker, always have been. And that's why, you know, level of concern. If you hear that term from the news, I got that from the news, actually.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was wondering where it came from.
I stopped watching the news. I just stopped watching it. I don't watch the news as I used to. I used to be like really watching it. But yeah, so the state of the world and, that song is just speaks to, and it's funny when I say Mama Africa, like that was, I think now it's just like ideology because at one time we felt like this was the best place, the safest place.
Mm-hmm.
We know it's the richest place in resources, but there's still so much corruption everywhere.
Right.
So it's a kind of like an idealist kind of song.
Oh. I love it. And based
you.
On the quick reactions I'm getting already, people out there are saying, yeah, that's a nice song. So I told the producer this morning that this is the one I'm gonna play next. Whatever you guys want to put out, that's a fool of business. But that's the one. That's a beautiful.
That's no problem. That's no problem. You know, it's just a blessing to know that this is someone from your generation. I mean, Junior Delgado. I wasn't blessed enough to meet him in person,
right.
But his spiritual music, the roots music that he was famed for. Lives, and that lives through my dad and through me. So, and a lot of people who sing roots music. So, just
wow.
Because I know that I'm not really the typical roots kind of singer, for me, it was that, you know, that tribute to say,
right.
Hey, I'm here. I love this. This is me, part of me.
Now, in terms of your writing, in terms of your writing style, as you just said, you watch the news, you see all these things, and obviously, to have a profound impact on how you write your songs.
Yes. Yeah, what I read, what I hear on the news, definitely. And conversations, you know,
right.
From the gimmicks in the video that you may see in your WhatsApp, you know, to seriousness, you just pull what you gravitate to. I gravitate
right.
to everything.
Right.
Even the foolishness, I gravitate to that too.
Right. Well, I mean, as a singer, you know, I get it all the while. Oh, Mr. Lindsay, I'm an artist. I try to please everybody and so on. I understand that. I get that. But as a veteran in this business and, you know, reach a stage, you know, I want some real sensible music. And this album offers more than sensible music because, you know, you work with a producer who tend to be shaping your direction. Am I right in that assumption?
Yes, Gary Sutherland loves up-tempo tracks.
Me too.
I do too. He loves up-tempo. I mean, he likes to dance. I love to dance too, you know that.
Yeah.
But I gravitate to lovers rock. Like, I love lovers rock. I love R&B. that's like me, totally. But singing-wise, I've always been able to sing on, like, up-tempo tracks. It's just that my two previous projects were geared more towards what I love to dance to. You know, I remember I fell in love with Sanchez music and that kind of vibe. So this definitely will, you'll hear, like, a variety, more up-tempo tracks.
And this the previous album, that the one rhythm, you produced that one rhythm, female. What's the name of
that? Oh, that one. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I thought you meant my album Higher. Queens in the Arena, Comet.
Queen
rhythm,
in the Arena.
All female.
This time you didn't get into the production and on this album, Level of Concern. Why not?
Strategically done. You know, I do want to produce more females. You see what's happening with their careers, right?
Yes, yes.
You know, I didn't have that chance when I was much younger for people to put me out. So, you know, I just wanted to be that vehicle. So I will be doing more work like that. But this, I definitely wanted them to lead that direction in terms of what tracks I like and reaching out to people like Fire House Crew, who knew me from when I was just singing in Jamaica.
Right.
So it's full circle. And Fire House Crew was on my first album. So it's nice to have them back on.
But as an artist and a producer, was it hard for you to just sit back on this album and allow someone to do the production? Was it hard for
not
you?
Not at all. I mean, I love working with people who know what they're doing.
Oh, okay. and for the most part, you have to go home at night, huh? For the most part, you have to go home, right?
Well, you know, I'm not hard to, I don't know. Many people will have different, you know, definitions of who I am, but I don't feel like I just know what I like and I know what I want. And they allow me the freedom to write because, you know, many people say that's a strength for me. So I just close the door and I just write.
Okay.
Let them do their thing. Let them do it. You
let
know, if I hear
it.
Something, I say,
like,
if I hear a harmony, you know, I'm going to just turn up a little bit, then they listen to me, which is nice.
It's like a driver. A driver don't like to be driven. You have to be real disciplined. Because, you know, your judgment, I know you see the road is different from the driver there. And as a passenger, I don't mind being driven, but I know somebody that I know, oh God, she knows every turn. I'm like, what?
Your wife.
I didn't call her name, but that's a driver that doesn't like to be driven, you know? And I've been driven years and years. I never had a major accident, but I'm telling you. Let's let it be for justice.
And I'm glad. Let me just stop right there for a second. You know, just the fact that I have you to really steer certain, you know, you give me a lot of advice, a lot of suggestions, a lot of directives and what, and I do listen.
You do.
You know,
you do.
So I like that. I like to, and I've always regarded that, someone who has more knowledge than I do in a field and just steered me, because that's what everyone should want.
Yeah, and I mean, I like you. I like you a lot, and I like people that try.
I love you. You like me, but I love.
I like people. Listen,
friends, musical friends.
Yeah, of course. I like to see artists that really try, and when they come to me, and I will suggest. Some of them cuss me out, you know. Don't get me wrong. So we say, well, I know some you want it, and I know some you do it. I'm saying, all right, whatever, but don't come to me to think I'm gonna play that crap, you know.
Right.
But when
right.
I give you advice, cause. You know, Freddie Marcia, Richie Steven, Josh Nooks, all of them come the same way. Not only the young artists, but those established artists. Well, Mr. Lindsay, what do you think about so and so? When I heard Let It Be for Justice, I had a sense of awareness that, you know, I think this girl is going in a different direction. Not knowing not knowing that the album was coming and what you were going to be offering on the album. Let It Be for Justice, very profound lyrics there. What again, you saw stuff on TV. Were you afraid to take that? Well, that's where you seem like you get your inspiration from. But were you afraid to, because people kind of know you as a dancehall, dancing type of girl, were you afraid to tackle a subject like, you know, like human rights?
You know, Gary always say, he's always the one that's very careful. You better watch it. I'm the more rebel, and he's a rebel too, but I'm more vocal about being a rebel, I think. But so, most times you're not going to hear a reggae R&B song, if you will, if that's the genre, I don't know, talk about that.
Right.
You know, you will hear that more in a culture song.
Or if it's Stevie Wonder, he's not afraid to go there.
Well, yeah, he's a genius. Yeah, you're right. And you played some Nina Simone, you know, but I don't hear it. Okay, so let me just rephrase that. I don't hear that nowadays.
Yes.
I don't. Maybe it's there. I hear it in hip hop, but not in the genre that I'm, you know,
right,
I just don't hear it. So that was a spin. Usually that track is kind of like a dance, a feel good track, and I just wanted to definitely bring some substance to it. Because I knew I had the other tracks to play with,
right,
to dance, so I just wanted to bring that to light. What? All the people around me that's dying, like, you know, people are killing our black men. I have a son who is, you know, a very promising youth that has a bright future, and, you know, God forbid it could be him.
Right.
That sticks really, really deep with me.
Were you surprised that the record took off, that, you know, actually people are playing the record, people are liking the record? Were you surprised at the reaction to it?
I was surprised because everyone's expecting me to sing Lovers Rock, which is what I'm, you know. So, yes, that was a surprise. It was a risk, definitely.
But it's true. You know, we fight and fight. We're not fighting for the real cause. You know what I mean? If we're going to fight, let it be for justice. If we're going to war, you know, we war with each other too much. The first person that came to me about China Nicole, I believe, was Don't Beat the Ruler. It was Don't Beat, and then after that, Fitzroy Francis.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
No, Don't Beat, I think, mentioned long time ago, when he mentioned you and that other girl that used to sing K Vibes or K.
Yep. Yes.
Yeah, that was the same time. And then Fritz, you were recorded by Fitzroy Francis, the first producer, right?
My dad actually was my first producer recording me. Yeah, McCall Williams, Gally Mouth Daddy.
Ah.
He was the first.
So when is
Detroit
it?
Managed me, and then we released.
Yeah.
When
will this album officially be available?
The pre-order for that same song you're playing, Top Pedigree on the Grind, and Level of Concern will be available the 29th of this month.
The 29th, okay.
But the full album will be available June 5th.
Are you going to make it available on a Sunday? Well, that's a new trend there. That's a Sunday, 29th. No, sorry. I'm looking at the month before. It will
You're
be next.
You're scaring me. I'm going to let you know.
No, I have two calendars. You know, like if I have May, I have also the month before. But the 29th will be next Friday.
Yes.
You know,
we do a research. They say it has more impact when you promote closer to the release date. That's what they say. I don't know.
Well, you have done your research, so you know. Are you excited about this album, as I am?
Yes. And I'm more excited than you're excited, actually. Because I'm like, this is my last. Every time I do an album, I'm like, this is my last album. It's just us. We're trying to do all of this. We don't have no label behind us. Big up to everybody to get signed. We don't have none of that. And we're just trying to make it happen. And it's just a lot of resources. And my family always said, you know, you could have so many businesses. You could put all your money in that music, but that's what I love. That's
right. But let me ask you: if a label approaches you, are you ready for that? Are you ready for it?
We are ready. We're definitely ready. We have a great team in terms of the production, the content. You know, George Miller already told me I'm a part of his team. He's a part of my team, like for life. So, and of course, Gary Sutherland. That's like, I have to big up Gary, but I thought that's like a no-brainer. But, you know, Gary Sutherland and Fitzroy Francis is always in my corner, you know. So I have a good team. I have Mark Clark. We have Noel Alfonso. We have some great, great musicians. Shola Henry from Nigeria. He's amazing. He's a teacher. He's a teacher, you know.
I was about to ask you.
Ooh. David Clark, yeah.
I know. Shola is a male. I was going to ask you, who is that lady, Shola? But you say it's a male.
He's a male from Nigeria. He's a teacher. I met him also years ago. He wanted to work with me, but just wasn't the right timing. And, mm-hmm. you know, me working with producers in Jamaica. And so finally he presented some tracks. And he's like, China, let's work. And he's a teacher, great.
So yeah. And he contributed two songs to the album?
Yes, sir. Yes.
All right. Yes. I tell you, girl, you hit the nail on the head with this album.
Wow, that's so awesome from you. That's really awesome that I'm hearing this from you. We regard you very highly. You've done so much for reggae music and for people in reggae music. And I'm very blessed 8 years ago that we crossed paths, and here you are telling me finally.
Here you are.
Finally, I breathe.
No, here you are. What is nice? Tell me about.
You're on my journey.
Okay. So. Tell me about Naya and Bingy. That's a nice little love song that I was listening to it last night. Real life situation or just lyrics?
Real life. I've used this metaphorically, of course, with man and female, husband and wife, but definitely real. We had birds, and our neighbors are the ones who kept complaining about our birds, and I'm so mad that we had to give up our birds. So we had to give up our birds because we traveled so much. We took them, but some places we couldn't take them.
Right.
And so it saddens me, but I'm happy that I have that memory. And so every time we hear this, we're like, Nyan Bingy, boy. Nyan Bingy.
Birds. You know, birds. I'm like thinking, I'm saying, wow, this is a nice love story. No, you're telling me. It's like Brandy. You know, when Brandy first came out, everybody thought Brandy was a woman. And then you found out it's a dog. I mean, this is about birds. Thanks a lot, China. It's about birds. Your neighbor, your birds are your neighbor's birds.
Our birds.
Your birds. Okay.
Yeah. But still, it's a love song. Like I said, metaphor.
It is.
Yeah.
Because I that's the way I was listening to it last night. And I must tell you, I get. As you can imagine, I get ton load of music album every day, every night. And when I really take an album and listen to it track after track after track, I do with this one. You must know, say, I'm feeling it.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, I'm feeling it.
Tons of Lindsay fans, are you hearing this?
Listen.
You mentioned Computer Paul. Big up Computer Paul.
Yeah, Computer Paul. When I tell people, you know, when they submit their stuff to me, and I say, you know, I got to find a hook in there where I can sell it. If I can't talk about it, if I'm ashamed to talk about it, then I can't take it. You understand what I'm saying? If I can come on the radio and say a brand new tune from China Nicole, blah, 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 I can't do it. It's not in me to do it.
Right. So, you're right. You have to feel it, right?
I have to feel it. You know, I'm not a singer or a musician, but I have this little gift. I have the ears. I can't tell you. Anyhow, sweetie, it's always a pleasure talking to you. And really, really, from the bottom of my heart, I'm wishing you best of luck with this album.
I thank you so much for endorsing it and being the first interview for this album.
Oh, it's the first one?
It's been in my corner since day one.
No.
Yeah, you're my first interview.
Well, good luck, and I wish you the best. And I'm sure that sooner or later, label is going to come knocking at your door.
Yeah, that would be great. That would be great and in any capacity, you know. So it'd be writing, it'd be singing, arranging, whatever. I'm at the point where I'm good, you know.
I just want
to do good music.
As you say, you have a good team behind you, and that's what it takes. And, you know, once you have that and you're ready to go, they will come knocking, sweetheart. Hey, listen.
That'd be great.
Good luck and continued success.
Thank you so much. Big up to Gary Sutherland, Jump Out Production, family, everybody.
Mr. Sutherland, I'm glad you have come on board, because I see the difference. I see the improvement. I hear the improvement. So whatever you're doing, sir, continue doing it. Hey, China.
Falling ear to ear.
China, this is ear to ear. All right. He knows I mean it. Hey, take the time to thank all the listeners around the globe who especially for Let It Be for Justice, very heavy on the request line.
Wow. Thank you so much, everyone who continues to support my music. I am here for you. I hope this album pulls you through whatever you're going through. It'll be available on the 5th, and you can pre-order 2 tracks that Lindsay just played for you on the 29th. And much success. Listen, whatever you're going through, believe in God, he will pull you through. He will.
All right. Give it all to him. You stay safe.
Thank you.
All right.